our opening prayer this morning. My brothers and sisters in Christ, in this season when we celebrate the birth of Jesus, let it be our delight to hear once more the message of the angels and go in heart and mind to Bethlehem to see the Son of God lying in a manger. As we hear the reading of God's holy word, let us rejoice that the glory of the Lord has been revealed. Let us find new hope in the promise that God is with us. Let us join with Mary and offer ourselves in service to God's holy, saving purposes for this world. And let us bless the name of the God of our salvation, who brings the dawn of forgiveness and salvation to those who live in the shadow of death and despair. Let us raise our voices with the messenger who announces good news of great joy to all people. And let us give thanks to the one whose power has made us children of God. As we mark once more the mystery of the Word made flesh, let us join with the song of angels and saints and make this place ring with our carols and hymns of praise. Let us remember the poverty of the birth of the Prince of Peace and pray for the poor, the cold, the hungry, and those among us who find that there is no room for them at the inn. Let us remember the flight of the Holy Family into Egypt and pray for the oppressed, refugees, the isolated, and those on the edges of our society. Let us remember that the Lord our God, the Lord of glory, experienced the pain of life and death, and pray for the sick, the stressed, the weary, the bereaved. And remember the promise that he shall reign forever and ever. Let us pray for the rulers of the nations, for peace and justice on earth, for the unity and mission of the church, that we may be a sign that God's rule on earth has already begun. With joy in our hearts, let us hear again the story of the birth of Christ and join with Mary and Joseph, with the shepherds, with the wise men, and with all our forebears in the faith in offering our worship and adoration to the Christ of Christmas. Amen.
Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. For he who had always been God by nature did not cling to his privileges as God's equal, but stripped himself of every advantage by consenting to be a slave by nature and being born a man. and plainly seen as a human being, he humbled himself by living a life of utter obedience to the point of death. And the death he died was the death of a common criminal. That is why God has now lifted him to the heights and has given him the name beyond all names, that at the name of Jesus every knee shall bow and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The voice of one crying in the wilderness, "Prepare the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God." Every valley shall be exalted, and every mountain and hill brought low. The crooked places shall be made straight, and the rough places smooth. The glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken.
Amen.
please be seated. Now, the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wise. When his mother Mary was espoused to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Ghost. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man and not willing to make her a public example, was minded to put her away privately. But while he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. Now all this was done that it might be fulfilled which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, God with us. A shoot will come up from the stump of Jesse. From his roots, a branch will bear fruit. The Spirit of the Lord will rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and of understanding, the spirit of counsel and of might, the spirit of the knowledge and fear of the Lord, and he will delight in the fear of the Lord. He will not judge by what he sees with his eyes or decide by what he hears with his ears, but with righteousness he will judge the needy. With justice he will give decisions for the poor of the earth. He will strike the earth with the rod of his mouth. With the breath of his lips he will slay the wicked. Righteousness will be his belt, and faithfulness the sash around his waist. The wolf will live with the lamb. The leopard will lie down with the goat, the calf and the lion and the yearling together, and a little child will lead them. The cow will feed with the bear. Their young will lie down together, and the lion will eat straw like the ox. The infant will play near the cobra's den, and the young child will put its hand into the viper's nest. They will neither harm nor destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth will be filled with the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea. In that day the root of Jesse will stand as a banner for the peoples. The nations will rally to him, and his resting place will be glorious. The desert and the parched land will be glad. The wilderness will rejoice and blossom. Like the crocus, it will burst into bloom. It will rejoice greatly and shout for joy. All will see the glory of the Lord and the splendor of our God.
Winter ever fuel me.
The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given. And the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace, there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever. The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this. There were shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. And the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths, lying in a manger." And suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to all people on whom his favor rests. When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Messiah was to be born. "In Bethlehem in Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet has written, 'But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me so that I too may go and worship him." After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshiped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route.
See? Story, for this is the morning God wakes us with.
He came down to earth from heaven, who is God and Lord of all. And his shelter was a stable, and his cradle was a stall. With the poor and mean and lowly, he lived on earth, our Savior holy. Not in that poor and lowly stable with the oxen standing by, we shall see him, but in heaven, set at God's right hand on high, when like stars his children crowned, all in white, around his throne. So go from this place with the wisdom of the wonderful counselor to guide you, with the strength of the mighty God, our Lord, to defend you, with the love of the everlasting Father to unfold you, with the peace of the Prince of Peace upon you, the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you all this day throughout the Christmas season. Go in peace. Merry Christmas. God bless you.
Biola University offers a variety of biblically centered degree programs, ranging from business to ministry to the arts and sciences. Visit biola.edu to find out how Biola could make a difference in your life.